and Daniel.
How are we doing? And with me is my texture-deprived friend, Daniel. And we're so honored to be here tonight. And we wanted to tell you a little bit about where we found our inspiration. And we really wanted to go back to kind of a neo-Victorian feel. So taking shapes and inspiration from a Victorian period and bringing it to a really modern, fresh, current time. So as you can see, we took elements of the past and tools from the future and what we're using currently in the salons to bring these looks to life. Daniel, why don't you talk a little bit about how we created these looks?
Well, first of all, when we create something like that, you have to create a foundation, and we use our total result of products to achieve that. And once you've got the base there with our products, then we use our tools. And what we use on, I've been with her all day today, and I just went like, sorry. Maria, oh my God, my mother's name.
Good thing you call her mom.
So we use a micro crimp on our hair, and this is something that we've been using quite a bit in the salon. And we micro crimp the whole entire head, and we use braids as well. And there's a braid that's down the center of her head here, and then we just kind of like pleated the hair onto the braid all the way down, and that's how we created that look. And we wanted to keep it more like Nick was talking about. We wanted to keep it the Victorian era, but we wanted to keep it fresh. So in the Victorian era, we had it was more rounded, and we went square and flat with this. So just to keep it a more modern look. And then we go ahead and using our, you know, curling iron, and we just curled the hair. And we want it to be very airy. And it depends on the tool you use and the texture of the hair that you're working with. She has very fine, light hair, and we wanted that. We wanted that just that soft-looking curls to the hair. So choosing the right tool, choosing the right hair to create your look. And then we went in also with the micro crimp. And this is one thing that I guess when you work with something like that with a braid down the back, I thought, let's just extend the braid. So what we did was we took the braid from the front all the way down to the center of the back, took the braid, lift it on top of each other, pin that, and then we just kind of like brought everything to the center. And just, you know, creating, you know, a different look, but keeping it the same era of what we were looking for.